Everyone, in this video, we're going to talk about what is known as the percent proportion. And so we're going to be able to do three things in this video. We're going to find a missing percent, we're going to find a missing part, and we're going to find a missing whole. So we have this proportion that we can write here, and it is x over y equals p over 100. And let's talk about what x, y, and p are. So we could use this statement, x is p percent of y. And so in this case, we could set it up as x being part of our whole number, so x is part of the whole y. So we have x over y would be what percent? So p over 100. So we're gonna find all three different variables here, because this question can be asked of you in three different ways. They might want you to find the percent, so that's giving you x and y and you gotta find p. They might want you to find the part, so that's giving you y and p, and they want you to find x. Or they might give you the, or they might want you to find the whole, so that's giving you x and p, and they want you to find y. Okay, so the toughest part of this for students that I've seen, that I've noticed, is just knowing which parts they're giving to us. Are they giving us the percent and the part? Are they giving us the part and the whole? Or are they giving us the whole and the percent? So once we figure that out, as long as we know this proportion, we can plug those values in, cross multiply, or use any other form of solving a proportion that we know of. In this video, we'll probably just cross multiply. In my opinion, I think that's the easiest. I know the numbers can be a little bit larger, but if you're able to use a calculator, that makes it even easier. But we can always cross simplify if we need to make those numbers a little bit easier to work with. So let's jump right in and let's start with finding a percent. So number one and number two, we're finding the same thing. We're gonna be finding p in this proportion. However, it's worded a little bit differently. So let's look at number one. It says, what percent of 24 is 6? So notice here it says what percent. So that's telling us right now, hey, we need to find p. Okay, so now we just need to know, is 24 the part or is 24 the whole? Same thing for 6. Well, what percent of 24 is 6? So it's asking us, hey, 24 is our whole, 6 is the part of it, what percent is that? So we could write this as 6 over 24 is equal to p over 100. Okay, so now I have a calculator here, so I'm not going to simplify or reduce anything for right now, because we can just use our calculator and multiply. So if I cross multiply, it's going to be 24 times p is equal to 6 times 100, so 600. And now let's divide both sides by 24. So I could do 600 divided by 24, and we get 25. So p is equal to 25. And so now we could write this as a percent and say 25%. Okay, so now that we know that, let's look back at 6 over 24. Well, if I look at those two numbers, 24 is divisible by 6, right? So we could have written 6 over 24 as 1 over 4, because if I divide 6 by 6, it's 1, and if I divide 24 by 6, it is 4, right? So we get 1 over 4, and so from here, maybe we have 1/4 memorized as a percent, right? It's like a quarter, 25%. Okay, so that might be another way to quickly do it. Or we could say, oh, okay, 1 over 24 equals p over 100. So 4 times 25 gets me to 100. So 1 times 25 would be my missing percent. So that's 25%. Okay, so multiple ways to attack a problem like this. But to me, cross multiplying is just an easy way to go about it. And there's always ways we can think about doing it in a different way. But let's go on with number two. 54 is what percent of 120? So it's asking the same thing, but it just looks a little bit different. So notice it still says what percent, okay? So now we have 54 is what percent of 120, okay? So now once again, I'm gonna cross multiply, so this would be 120p is equal to 5,400. And then we're gonna divide by 120. So 5,400 divided by 120, that's gonna give me 45. Okay, so now I could say this is 45%. Okay, so 54 is 45% of 120. Okay, so for this one, these numbers are a little bit larger, right? So it might be harder to reduce off the bat. Also, to go from 120 to 100, right? I'm trying to think about maybe an easy way to do that. We could divide by, not sure, right? We would have to think about that one, how we would get there. Okay, so like I said, cross multiplying might be your easiest way just to go about it, especially if you have a calculator that you're able to use. Okay, so those are the first two examples where we find the percent. Now let's move on to find a part. Okay, so we're still using the same proportion, x over y equals p over 100. Now it says, what number is 80% of 60? So now notice it says, what number? Okay, so we're given the percentage now. So now we know that this would be 80 over 100. So what number is 80% of 60? So we're trying to find out if 60 is down here, we're trying to find the part. Okay, so if we look back up at our proportion, x over y equals p over 100, we don't know the part, we know the whole is 60, the percent is 80. So now let's go from here. So we have 60, 80, 100, let's do 60 times 80, that's gonna be 4,800 is equal to 100x. Okay, and so now we can divide both sides by 100, which is just going to eliminate these two zeros here. So we're gonna end up with x being 48. So 48 would be the number that is 80% of 60. Okay, so x is 48 for number three. All right, number four, 0.5% of 300 is what number? So once again, what number? And we have our percent here, 0.5 over 100 is equal to what number over 300? So now let's do 300 times 0.5, and that gives me 150 is equal to 100x. We divide by 100. Okay, now for this one, it's maybe not as simple to just cross off our zeros, but remember what's happening when we're dividing by 100. We're moving that decimal twice to the left. So this is gonna be 1.5. Okay, so 150, move the decimal one would be 15, another would be 1.5. Okay, so there's our two examples of how we could find a part. Now our last example here, we're gonna find a whole, which would be y. All right, so 15 is 30% of what number? So once again, we have what number here? So we have 30%, so 30 over 100. Now 15 is 30% of what? Which means 15 is our part and we're trying to find the whole. Okay, so now y times 30 would be 30y and 15 times 100 would be 1,500. Okay, let's divide both sides by 30. All right, so now we can think about this. Okay, 1,500 divided by 30, that's gonna give me 50. So y would be 50. For this one. So 15 is 30% of 50, okay? All right, number six, last example, 25% of what number is 9? So now we have 25 over 100, okay? And we're trying to figure out 9 would be 25% of what, okay? So let's do 25y is equal to 900, and then let's divide both sides by 25. Okay, so 900 divided by 25, and that gives me 36, okay? So another one for this one, we see the 25% there. So we could have thought of 25 over 100 as 1/4, right? And then if we think about going backwards, so like this, 9 over y equals 1 over 4. If I go this way, I would need to multiply by 9. So I need to multiply by 9 as well, and 9 times 4 would be 36. Okay, so that's another way we could think about how to fill out our proportion there and find our missing whole number. Okay, so that is known as the percent proportion, and that's how we can use that proportion to find a missing percent, a missing part, and a missing whole.